Hello dear students, I'm assistant professor Rushali Ahel, and in the last session of fermentation technology part 2, we have already started with the penicillin, and we have already studied the history and introduction about the penicillin. Now we will actually start with the industrial production of the antibiotic, including specifically penicillin production. So the antibiotic production method. Generally, the antibiotics are produced on an industrial scale using variety of fungi and bacteria. If we consider about the penicillin, this penicillin, it is produced by using fungus Penicillium chrysogenum. This Penicillium chrysogenum, it is highly stable strain which can produce penicillin in large amount at the industrial level. So it is selected and used for the high yield production of penicillin. Generally, penicillin chrysogenum, it requires lactose and other sugars as a carbon source as well as nitrogen source for their proper growth and development. This penicillin, it is a secondary metabolite, so it is generally produced only in the stationary phase. Generally, for the production of penicillin in the industrial scale, it requires batch fermenter or feed batch fermentation process can also be used, because in the feed batch process, normally a prolonged stationary period can be used, which increases the production of the penicillin. Now let's start with the industrial production of antibiotic penicillin. Now the industrial production of penicillin is broadly classified in two processes or in two steps. One includes your upstream processing and second one is your downstream processing. Now if we see the diagrammatic representation, the production or the outline chart of penicillin fermentation, it includes simple steps. One is our culture of Penicillium chrysogenum, it is present in the lyophilized form and it is preserved. So first we go for the inoculum development. So we produced a large scale inoculum or the seed culture, then this seed culture, it is added in the pre-fermenter. When it is added in the pre-fermenter, this seed culture, it is then added in the fermenter, where this fermenter, it contains nutrients containing your carbon source, nitrogen source and other minerals required for the growth of Penicillium chrysogenum. Then in the fermenter we add our inoculum. Proper aeration and agitation is provided, and then this fermentation process, it is run for near about 7 days. After this, a proper production of penicillin, it is carried out. After this, we go for the downstreaming process, in which we go through filtration or centrifugation process, which helps in the separation of mycelium and other media components. Then the liquor, it is added in the cooling tank, and further purification process of the antibiotic, it is carried out. It is a simple outline of the penicillin production in the fermentation process. Let's go through all these processes in detail one by one. So we'll start with the upstream processing. Upstream process, basically it includes inoculum development, selection of microorganism, and our actual fermentation process. So the media is designed according to the need of the organism. The organism, it is provided with all the nutrients that it requires for its growth and मल्टीप्लिकेशन. जनरली इनोक्युलेशन मेथड और द इनोक्युलम डेवलपमेंट इट इज कैरीड आउट विद द सबमर्ज टेक्निक एंड स्पोर्स आर द मेजर सोर्स विच आर यूज फॉर द इनोक्युलेशन पर्पजेस. अपस्ट्रीम प्रोसेसिंग इट encompasses any technology that leads in the synthesis of the product. Means the upstream process, it is the process which carry out the synthesis of the product. It includes exploration, development and the production. So we'll start with the raw materials. Raw materials required for the production of the media. So our second point is media designing. It includes carbon source. Basic carbon source, it is provided with the help of lactose sugar. Lactose acts as a very satisfactory carbon compound, provided that is used in the concentration of 6%. In 6% concentration, generally the lactose sugar, it is used as a carbon source. Other than lactose, other sugars such as glucose or sucrose, they may be used in the production of penicillin. Whereas cornstarch liquor is a major source of nitrogen source. Other than cornstarch liquor, ammonium sulfates or the ammonium acetate can also be used as a nitrogenous source for the growth of penicillium chrysogenum. Then raw material also includes different kinds of mineral sources like potassium, phosphorus, magnesium, sulfur, zinc, copper are very essential for the penicillin production. Some of these, they may be applied by the cornstarch liquor also. The cornstarch liquor, which is a great source of nitrogen, it also contains small amount of mineral sources. Whereas for the penicillin production, we also require calcium source. The calcium can be added in the form of chalk to counter the natural acidity of the cornstarch liquor. To control the natural acidity of cornstarch liquor, the calcium source or chalk, it is added in the medium. Whereas PAA is added as a precursor, which starts the activity of all these components. So once our media it is properly designed and inoculum is developed, then we go through the fermentation process. Generally here, batch fermentation or the feed batch fermentation process is used. For this, the media it is properly sterilized at 121 degrees Celsius and then added. Then the medium it is inoculated with the suspension of conidia of Penicillium chrysogenum. Once the inoculation process is completed, then the medium it is constantly aerated and agitated. Aeration is carried out by passing sterile air in the fermenter, and agitation it is provided by the shakers present inside the fermenters. And this aeration and agitation, it is done for the proper growth of molds in the form of pellets. And the process is then started. This process is continued for about 7 days. During these 7 days, the growth of Penicillium chrysogenum is completed and the pH of the fermenter it rises to 8 or above. And at this pH, the penicillin production is completed, and once the pH reaches up to 8, the penicillin production stops. So this indicates, or this pH rise indicates that the process of penicillin production have been completed. See, here you can see the fermenter which is used for the production of penicillin. We add all the nutrients in this, then the inoculation process, it is carried out completely. A pH monitor system and temperature monitor system, it is completely automated process, and pH and temperature monitors are set in the fermenter. Cooling water or cool water, it is passed through the pipeline set outside the fermenter, which helps in the temperature controlling purposes. Here you can see the stirrer paddles are set, which helps in the proper agitation. A sterile air is passed in the fermenter for the aeration process, and the process of fermentation is carried out. Once the process is completed, the antibiotic, it is removed from the upper part of the fermenter. Here is the graphical representation of the production of antibiotic. Basically, whenever the bacteria is in its log phase or exponential phase, the rapid production of antibiotic is seen in that phase, and gradually it becomes steady in the stationary phase. So the main stage of penicillin production includes 5 steps. First one is media of Constip liquor, yeast extract and other substrates are added in the fermenter. Means first we add medium in the fermenter, then after 40 hours the penicillin begins to secrete by the fungus. In the first 40 hours, what happened? The lag phase of the fungus Penicillium chrysogenum, it starts very slowly. So in previous 40 hours, a slow growth of Penicillium chrysogenum is observed, where it does not produces penicillin. Once it enters in the lag phase or the exponential phase, after 48 hours, the actual penicillin production or the penicillin secretion by the fungus is started. Then once the penicillin secretion or the production is completed, the molds or the mycelium, they are separated by the filtration process, and then penicillin, it is extracted in the organic solvents like butyl acetate, and then different types of salts like potassium salts are added, which helps in the precipitation of penicillin. Then this after the precipitation of penicillin, this penicillin, it is washed, it is dried, it is further purified, and then it is used for the marketing purposes. So up till now we have seen the upstream process of penicillin production, in which we have seen the actual production of penicillin. Now we will start with the downstream in processing. The downstream process is the extraction and purification of biotechnological product from the fermentation process. Once the product, it is produced, the extraction or the removal of that product and purification of that product is done in the downstream processing. Generally, In the first stream of downstreaming process, the product, it is removed or separated from the fermenter. Then the whole cells or the mycelium, they are separated with the help of filtration technique. For the first step, the product recovery is the separation of whole cell and other insoluble ingredients from the culture broth by the techniques such as filtration and centrifugation. Filtration and centrifugation process, it helps in the separation of mycelium of Penicillium chrysogenum, whereas all the insoluble contents present inside the medium. Then, once the first step it is completed, which includes the removal of mycelium and the cells with the help of filtration or centrifugation process, the second step is the removal of antibiotic or the separation of antibiotic from the spent production medium. This separation of antibiotic, it is carried out by using solvent extraction process or adsorption process with the help of activated carbon or by the precipitation process. Different types of additional solvents like solvent extraction, distillation, sublimation, column chromatography and other methods can be used for the purification of penicillin or the antibiotic. Other semi-synthetic penicillins like semi-synthetic such as penicillin, ampicillin, methicillin, oxicillin, propicillin are prepared by chemical acylation of 6-amino penicillinic acid. So, once the antibiotic it is separated by the solvent extraction or the precipitation process, the instability of the penicillin molecule under acidic conditions and its low concentration in the fermentation broth requires the development of extraction equipment. So, basically, water immiscible extraction solvent are used for the extraction of penicillin, and it is rapidly extracted, and then this penicillin it is neutralized. Once the penicillin it is converted into stable form, the assay for standardization of penicillin it is carried out, means whether this penicillin it is effective or not it is checked. This process it is checked by the agar well diffusion test, means a proper plate containing agar medium is taken, a lawn of specific bacterial culture is prepared on it, and then wells of are prepared with the help of cork borer, and in these wells the antibiotics or the penicillin which we have produced is added. These plates are incubated for 24 hours, and after 24 hours the zone of inhibition is observed. If a proper zone of inhibition is observed, then it is stated that this antibiotic is effective, and this process it also helps to determine the exact concentration which can be prescribed, and this can be done by preparing various dilutions of the antibiotic. So this was all about the production, that is upstream process of penicillin, and the separation and purification of penicillin, that is downstreaming process of the production of penicillin. So here we complete with the industrial production of the penicillin. So let's conclude with this session, which states that when life gives you molds, we can make penicillin, which can save thousands of lives which get infected with the various harmful infectious agents. Thank you.